Hello and welcome. My name is Robin and you're watching A Robin Reads. Today I want to talk to you about my January TBR. So this is the PAL I got for it. It's like 15 books, I think, and that's a lot, but yeah, I'm just gonna see how far I get, and yeah, that's pretty much it. So let's get started. So the first books I want to show you are two NetGalley arcs I'm going to read. They're on my tablet right here. These books I'm going to show you in a vlog, so I'm not going to talk to you about the summary and stuff, because yeah, you will see that in my vlog. So the first one is coming out on the... Ooh, it's really glary. Sorry. No. Is this better? Yeah, sort of. Okay, this is the first book. It's called On the Isle of Sound and Wonder by Alison Grauer. This book is out on the 7th of January, and it's basically a fantasy novel. And this I'm going to read for that vlog, so watch out for that later. And the other one is this one, Strange Exit by Parker Peavyhouse. This is a science fiction YA, I believe. So those are the two NetGalley arcs I'm going to read. Then I will insert a clip here of the choosing of my TBR jars. Hi, so today I wanted to do my TBR pick with you guys. I have two TBR jars over here and I'm gonna pick three books out of them. So let's see what they are. This is the first TBR jar I'm going to pull a book out of, and this is going to be my big book for the month of January. So, let's see what it is. I'm a little bit frightened. Let's pick this one. So, The Canterbury Tales by Geoffrey Chaucer. I hope I pronounced that right. So that's gonna be my big book for the month of January. The next two books I'm going to pick from this big tobacco pot. It has got all the books I own in it, and it's like 300 books, so let's pick one. So, I've got two. The first one is a Dutch book. You will see in a minute which one it is. It's called Snikken and Grimlachjes by Piet Paaltjens. And the next book is Lightning by Danielle Steele. So, this is going to be very interesting, and I'm very excited about reading these books because they have been on my TBR for a long time. So I'm very excited that I will be reading them in January. So back to the video. So I've got two TBR jars. The first one is a TBR jar of big books I'm going to read this month, and I will pick just one book each month to read. And I also have a TBR jar for my own books. So I'm going to talk to you about those first. The first one is this one, Lightning by Danielle Steele. Danielle Steele, I have a lot of books by her, but I haven't read a lot of them. I think I read like three, but that's like a lot of years ago. So I'm curious to see if I like this. This book is fiction, romance kind of novel, and I'm not really sure what it's about, but I go into my books pretty blind, So I will talk to you about this one in my wrap-up. The next book on my TBR is this one. This is a Dutch book. This is Dutch literature, and I can't really translate it because it's really difficult Dutch words. But I'm just going to read this one, and it's really short, so that's great. And the big book I'm going to read this month is this one. These are the Canterbury Tales. I got this one in a thrift shop, and yeah, it just I was in Canterbury like 2, 3 years ago, and I loved it. It's just so amazing. It looks great, and yeah, it's just amazing. And this book is of that city basically. And just tales, and yeah, it doesn't look that long, but it's over 500 pages. That is really the mark that I set for myself for those big books. So I'm gonna read this one. The next book I'm going to talk about is my reading challenge I'm going to do this year. I didn't talk about it in my 2020 reading plans because I didn't have the plans then, but I'm going to do a reading challenge called the monthly reading challenge of keywords. I will link it down below. And basically, you have to read books that have the keywords in the title. So, for example, this one had the keyword this. So, this is this year it will be different by Maeve Binchy. As you saw in my reading plans of 2020. I have a lot of Maeve Binchy books, and I want to read them all this year so I can just, get rid of them probably. And this is a short story collection, so yeah, I'm looking forward to this one. The next one I'm going to read is this one. It's called Freshwater by this author. I'm not going to pronounce it. It's really hard. And the keyword was water. So this one I saw on the channel Laurenandthebooks. She read this book, I think, and she really loved it because it's about a teenage girl who has different personalities, and yeah, she just tries to deal with that. So it sounds really interesting. The next book I want to talk to you about is a book I'm going to read for a book club. This is a Dutch book club, and we read a book every month. This month the theme was to read a childhood favorite, basically. I put in the BFG by Roald Dahl because that is really a favorite of mine. But another one won, and that's this one. It's called Kruistocht in Spijkerbroek. And the translation is like Crusade in Jeans. This book I read as a child, and I remember that I think I liked it. Not sure, it was a long time ago. So I'm just going to reread this book and see what I think about it now. The next book I'm going to read is this one, Circe by Madeline Miller. This is going to be a buddy read with someone of the same group as I mentioned earlier. I read A Song of Achilles last year, this year, 2019, and really loved it. So I was curious to see what I thought of this book. And this book is about, Circe, god or something, I'm not sure. And yeah, I hope I really like this one too. So then, going into the two library books I'm going to read for this month, Jess from Jes Marie is going to read all of the Dark Tower books in January. I'm not sure if she's really going to do it, but she mentioned it in one of her videos, and I thought, why not join? But I'm not going to read all the books in January because I don't like to binge read series. I'm not really good at that. I just get bored really easily, pretty much. That sounds a bit weird, but yeah, it's just what it is. So, therefore, I'm going to read the first two books in Dutch. So, this is the Dutch edition, and I think the first one is called Gunslinger in English. I heard that this one is not that great, So I am just going to push through and then look into the next book, which is this one. This one is called, I think, The Sign of Three, if it's translated the same way. And I'm just gonna read this one and, yeah, rate it on this, because the other one wasn't good, I heard, so yeah. Therefore, I'm just gonna base my rating more on this one. And yeah, this series is about, a gunslinger. And it's like a fantasy or sci-fi series. And yeah, it just really sounded interesting. And I really want to read more by Stephen King, because yeah, a lot of you guys seem to like him. So I want to try his books, really. And this is not a horror book, and I really don't like horror. So yeah, I'm looking forward to this one. Then on to the books I'm going to read for a book club called the Devour Your TBR book club. I will link it down below. This is a book club that has prompts for every month, and you need to read books for that prompt. So in January, the prompt was to put books in a jar, books you wanted to read in 2019 and didn't get to, and just pick books out of that jar. But I already have two jars, as you saw in my previous clip, so I'm not going to do that. I just picked out some books I want to read last year and didn't get around to. So the first book is this one. It's also the Dutch edition, sorry about that. I will link the English editions all down below. This is the second book in the Wayward Pines series by Blake Crouch. This is a science fiction series, and it has a great thriller aspect to it. I really liked the first book. I gave it, I think, 4 stars. I think it wrapped up really nicely. So it had a really nice closed ending. So I was like, am I going to continue? But I think I will try. And yeah, I'm really curious to see how he's going to continue with the story, because it just had a very nice ending. So looking forward to this one. Another book I wanted to read last year but didn't get around to was this one, Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde and Other Stories by Robert Louis Stevenson. I read Treasure Island a couple of years back and really loved it, so I don't know why I didn't pick it up. Just, it's classic, and classics sometimes really put me off. But Treasure Island was actually really accessible, so I think I will really like this book, and it's pretty short, so if I just push through, I will probably just finish this pretty easily and pretty quickly. Another book I'm going to be reading is this one. You can't really see it, but it's the third book in the Underland Chronicles by Suzanne Collins. This is called The Curse of the Warmbloods. And this series is about a guy named Gregor, and he is, on one day he just falls into a hole, just like Alice in Wonderland basically, and he goes down and comes into the Underland. And the Underland is a really scary place, and yeah, it's just, he gets on an adventure, and yeah, it has the Chosen One trope, so yeah, it's really good. And this is the third book, so I'm really curious to see how the story goes on. Then another series I'm going to read, this is also a middle grade series, the other one is two. This is the Diary of a Wimpy Kid series, written and I think also drawn by Jeff Kinney. This is a series about a guy named Greg. Greg is middle grade school, and he's just really funny, and he has a journal, not a diary, and he writes in a journal, and yeah, just basically what he's up to in all of the days. And I really like the drawings in the book. They're really funny and just really yeah, just really cute. And I can probably read this book in like one day because it's like 230 pages most of the time. And yeah, just a really easy and quick read. Then, the last book already. So, that is a book I wanted to finish this series. Yeah, finished this series last year, but it's just a lot. So I will put it off until January, but I really want to finish it in January or either February. And that is the Song of Ice and Fire series by George R. R. Martin. This is the fifth book, called Dance with Dragons. And the last book, A Feast for Crows, really disappointed me, actually. It was, the first half was really slow and there wasn't a lot happening, and it was actually pretty boring, so I didn't really like that one. But he wrote in the epilogue, I think you call it, right? Like, he chose to separate the characters. So a couple of characters are in A Feast for Crows and the other characters are in this one. And actually my favorite characters are in this one. For example, Tyrion Lannister, I really like. He's in this one. Jon Snow, Daenerys Targaryen, etc. So I think this one will be better than the last one, and I'm really, really looking forward to it. But it's really long. It's like, I think, 1200 pages. So I might just read it in two parts, which I have done previously, and probably will finish this in like February or something. But I will definitely start reading it in January. Hello again. I forgot to tell you something that I will also be doing in January, so that's why I'm doing this like vlog style. I will be joining a readathon. It's called the AYearAthon, and that's happening every month. And this month's theme was pick a color and read books from that color. So I'm going to show you in my pile which books I'm going to read for that. So this is my pile for January. So as you can see, there are a couple of books that have the same color. The color is black. So I'm gonna read one of these or both in that week. It's a week, I think the second whole week in January. So I think the 13th will start, I think. So I'm going to read the first one in the Dark Tower series, I think, and this one. This is a body read, so I'm not going to read this one. And I'm going to read Lightning, because, yeah, that's really, really black. So that's three books I'm going to read in that week. So thank you for watching. Bye. So those are the books I'm planning to read in January. I'm really looking forward to the new year and starting all those exciting books. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Please let me know what your plans are for January. And give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Comment and subscribe, and I will see you later.